Okay. Hey, guys. Blackstreet here at your service, playing a bit of Star Wars Battlefront 2. The newer version, not the older version. Even though the older version was a great game for its time. Massive Star Wars fan. And I was actually a Grand Admiral of Star Wars Galaxies. Right, okay, let's see what's going on here then. Don't be an officer. Yeah, good gold Imperial Sniper, I suppose. Yeah, give it a shot. Oh, is that quick, was it? Where are we? Kamino? No? Bespin. To get out of the way. Whoa.
Watch the rebound. We're off their sensors.
All the Galactic Empire. Right, okay. One down. Whoa. Okay. Cool sniper again. So where does this go? Rebel scum. Oop. Oh shit, we're gonna do that. Trying to wipe myself out here a little bit. Hey viewers, how are you today? Hey, how's it going, guys? Nice to see you with me, man. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Welcome in, welcome in. Come on in to the boudoir. Whoa. Installed. If for some reason it was uninstalled, I don't know. I'm a massive Star Wars fan. You know, I remember watching Star Wars, the first movie, Episode 4 as it's called now. The day it was released, first of all.
Running
sensor interference. Grenade deployed. 1977. Oh. Let's fall back a little bit. Whoa! It in the face, mate. For the Empire. Yeah, well, I played Grand Admiral. Grand Admiral Morgan Deathwalker on Star Wars Galaxies. Had my own command ship, or Imperial Super Star Destroyer, the Devastator. That was my ship. I had 8 support Star Destroyers. I think it was roughly close on 1,800 actual players working for me, running everything, running the ships, you know, troops as well. So yeah, 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 they were great days. Yeah, it is a great game. Oh, yes. Very naughty, yes. don't often play as a scout or a sniper, so it's not as good time I give it a shot. I spin. Those them, they're my guys. Oh, a twat. Oh, it's old age, that's what I'm putting it down to. Old age, senile dementia, however you want to term it. I'm not a young man anymore. Oh, I'm still funky. Victory for the Empire. That's what it's all about. Nice cup of tea, ladies and gentlemen. Well, I hope you're having a fine day there, my friend. Hey, Draco Slings! Yes! Bit of a victory for the Empire there, my friend. Oh yeah, my character. I was thinking then, why is it put Morticia up there? Because that's one of my old Sith Lords on the Old Republic. Darth Morticia. Who I play as like a roleplay character. She's like the daughter of Darth Nihilus. That's it. So I play her that way, you know. I return to main menu. Let's choose another map then. Let's give it a shot. What we got here then. Alright, let's have a look. Tatooine Jabba's Palace. Not in Kessel. Ah, oh, give it a shot. Yeah, Kessel. Go on, give Kessel a go. How hard can it be, yeah? I think I'll probably go Heavy Trooper for this, though. It's the mine. Okay, Quaxian mine. I'm getting back into this, you know. I haven't played this for couple of months, actually, maybe 4 months, but I was never really good at it anyway. I had it on sale, so I thought, I'll buy that while it's cheap. Uh, I do like the standard Stormtrooper with the E11 though. Oh yes, so we'll give that a shot. Okay, ladies and gents, let's do this then. I'm not too familiar with this. I think I've played it once before. Going on here with the old sniper. Unless you're Imperial, of course. Oh, I have played this one, yeah. It's not a bad map. Spice Mines of Kessel. Guys, today, hope you're having a great day. Yay, yay, yay! For the Empire, my friends, one day I'll actually play Star Wars Galaxies again. I know there is a private server going on it. I do miss launching my troops and taking over rebel planets and sending in AT-ATs with troop, complements on board each. This is an outside, okay. Thank you. claw back a bit. So, what's been happening in your neck of the woods, then, ladies and gents? Anything interesting going on? Oh, down we go. Oh, nice cup of tea to wet the vocal cords and tonsils, huh? Right, we'll try heavy a sec. I'll try it heavy on this one. Okay. I'm not too familiar with this map, to be honest with you.
Watch for shrapnel!
Oh, balls. The wrong option there, I think. Oh, so somebody loves this game. I don't believe it. I'll try officer. Okay, give it a shot.
Grenade up!
Victory for the Empire, ladies and gents. How are you doing today? Huh? Trying out these maps I am at the moment. I haven't really played this game much, so thought it was about time I gave it a shot. Played the first one quite a bit. Played the originals as well, but I picked this up on sale in British money. I think it was about £3, which would be about $5 to $6 if I'm correct in money. I could go with the USD. Okay, try another map then, a different scenario. Okay, going good. Okay. First order, ugh, doesn't exist in my head, sorry. Aha! What's this? This is a space one, isn't it? Death Star debris. Yeah, Starfighter, that is. Okay. Abandoned Rebel Outpost, okay. Give in a shot once. Crate, I know. Episode 8, isn't it? Crate. If you like them three films. Episode 7 was interesting. Episode 8 and 9, I don't know. 9 had its moments, but 8. Female soldiers, excellent. Well, there were quite a few women played stormtroopers in the original films, if I remember correctly. Well, okay, going as a standard trooper. Okay, let's try something else. Team battle, that's the word. Naboo Palace. Okay, yeah, why not? I said to where it all begun. Lovely, nice cup of tea there. Roger, roger. Okay. can there be? He was shit, so I'll give him that. Oh, no. Clanker, that's what they call me, you I like that heavy attack, but it's not a very good one to be honest. It's heavy again. How would you feel pain, Floyd? fucking heads. Roger, roger. Starfighters, okay. Victory for us, I should think. Vector, hey, 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 King! Lovely to see you. Welcome, welcome, welcome. I'm having a bit of Star Wars going on here, yeah. Never really got into this game, but I'm a massive Star Wars fan. I remember watching Star Wars Episode 4 the day it was first released in 1977. A day that I will never, ever forget. Nobody knew what to expect. There was all this hype about it, and we knew a couple of things because of the toys which had come out at the time, the action figures. I had Chewbacca, I had R2-D2, I had Darth Vader, a couple of Stormtroopers. But we just knew their names from the box. What was a Darth Vader, really? Was he a good guy, bad guy? All right, he's black. His armor's black, so is he good? Is he bad? Are these the good soldiers? We didn't know what to expect from Star Wars. And then I watched the film and I was like, oh, that's awesome. And two things I took away from that movie when I was a kid. Stormtroopers, Vader didn't even impress me. I didn't even draw towards Vader or anything to do with Darth or the Sith or the Jedi. None of that impressed me. Stormtroopers, I loved the Stormtrooper look. Obviously the rifles, that was just amazing. But the other thing I took away from Star Wars the first time I watched it, was the Sand People, the Tusken Raiders. I was like, wow. And I think a little while later, my cousin had been over to the United States, and he came back and he brought me the United States action figure, which was slightly better than the British version. And I was like, wow. You know, and if I had that now, probably worth a lot of money, but I don't. I shot them with my air rifle when I got into my teenage years. Yeah, sadly. Been a twit. But out of the originals, Star Wars figures, I think my favourite out of all of them was the Death Squad Commander. I don't know why, I just liked the look of the grey uniform and the helmet, and, you know, he was a trooper, wasn't he, you know. But yeah, onward and upward we go, my friend. Thank you for joining. Oh yeah, Star Wars. I played Star Wars The Old Republic as well. I recently picked up Knights of the Old Republic 1 and 2 for less than £3 on cdkeys.com. And I love them. Beautiful storyline. Yeah, yeah, yeah. You know, I play Sith Empire. I can't play Jedi. Or the Republic side of things. It has to be. It's like in the precursor, episodes 1, 2 and 3, I would have had to be a separatist. I really would, and I could not have played for the Republic. Just... In fact, on a roleplay note, I play a character called Darth Morticia, a female version of Darth Nihilus. So I thought, on a roleplay, I'll play her as his daughter. So, yeah. 300 years later, during the time of the Old Republic, she was revived from a stasis chamber by Jawas on Tatooine, where all of his loyalists had been, you know, locked away. And I took the stasis chamber from Red Dwarf. Yes, I know. I mixed it up a bit there. Maul was very interesting when he first came out. Shame they didn't do much with him in the film. You know, the whole Grievous thing. Was he a Kalish, wasn't he, before he was robotized? If you go by... I don't count this canon and legends BS. I count it all as Star Wars. It's all important to me, like, you know. It's like when I played, I was one of the Grand Admirals on Star Wars Galaxies on the server. I was one of the 12. And I had my own Super Star Destroyer called the Devastator. I had 8 Imperial Star Destroyers as my escort ships. And yeah, we went around dropping troops on rebel planets and invading quite often. You know, when I can send down 100 players, actual players... I actually had 1,800 close on actual players serving under me, running my command ship, running, obviously you didn't need as many in a game but than you would have in the Star Wars, you know, universe. But yeah, I had 1,800 players running my Super Star Destroyer, running my 8 Star Destroyers, you know, that involved troops as well. So say 800 of them would have been ground forces. I choose, when it comes to, this is what I don't like about games like this, I'm not being negative here, it forces you to play both sides. I can't stand that. And, you know, you choose your loyalty, you choose your faction, and you fight loyally for it. That's what I did in Galaxy, that's why I loved Galaxy so much. I suppose with Soto as well, I only play Sith Empire. You know, It's since when you can put your character, because, you know, I grew up through heavy metal, so really it suits that kind of vibe that you can put yourself into the character. And, you know, obviously I'm not evil, I don't go around killing people with a lightsaber in real life, but all that from many years ago, teen angst, of growing up through metal and and all this, you know, and just chuck that energy into a character. I find it beautiful. Wonderful, yeah. Get all that vibe, you know, vibe. Yeah, I used to on Star Wars Galaxies, I remember we'd wait until the Rebel players, because most Rebel players on that game were kids and teenagers. We'd wait till their mummies had sent them to bed, really, and then we'd just attack their planets. We'd attack their fleet when there was very few of them about. Like, at the end of that game, we were screwed out of a victory by the admins running the servers, because I was the last Imperial Grand Admiral still active. I was working with the server admin playing Darth Vader, and he was giving me my orders at Bestine, it was, on Tatooine. And I've actually got screenshots to prove all this, of me having my orders off Vader. And then he sent me because I was also one of the Emperor's personal protectors, because yes, the Emperor did exist on Star Wars Galaxies. He had a palace on Naboo out in the sticks, and I was one of his personal protectors. I never saw Mara Jade or any of that side, which I wish I had, actually, because I think she's pretty cool, pretty mysterious character. You know, but I just picked up, funny enough, talking about Star Wars, I just picked up the Star Wars Dark Forces, Jedi Knight Dark Forces 2, Mysteries of the Sith expansion for that. I picked up Jedi Outcast, Jedi Academy on cdkeys.com. I think it was about page 40 or 41. And I just picked all them games up for about £3 in British money. So say $5, $5 to $6 for 5 games. All right, the graphics aren't there, but they were good for the time. You know, you're talking 1996 upwards. So yeah, you know, I just picked them up. I did play Jedi Fallen Order, and to be honest with you, on PC, I thought it was a bit too consolated. You know, it was a bit too reliant on having a controller, which I don't. I'm a keyboard and mouse user. I love keyboard and mouse. I just absolutely love Star Wars, anything Star Wars. What I find about the Old Republic is, you can't knock it. Like, you know, for that kind of money, £3 for 5 games. I'm waiting now. I'm going to be looking on there for the old space ones, you know, like TIE Fighter and X-Wing, and X-Wing versus TIE Fighter. What was the other one? X-Wing Alliance, wasn't it? I see them 4 games on there going cheap. I'll buy them as well. So I want to stream. I love streaming. I love talking to you guys. You know, it's really cool. Like, you know, I've always been pretty chatty anyway, but usually within my own comfort zone. And it's nice now through the internet to be able to get out there and say hi. You know, I'm an old fart. I hope you don't mind talking to an old fart. You know, just talk old fart, you know. Oh, yeah, definitely. When you see a good deal like that. It's like I bought the Old Republic game when it first came out, the standard version. It was cheap enough, even when it came out, it was £20, you know. I say £20, probably $30 then, roughly. And after a while, I thought, this game's good, but I'm going to have a look for a deal on this. So I looked for the collector's edition, and I picked the collector's edition up, which I have on the shelf here. It was £150 when it came out. I got it for £80 with the statue of Malgus and got all that here. Yeah. Hey, there's nothing wrong with being an old fart. Are you this side of the pond, or are you over in the US Canadian side? Are you more towards the east? I should ask also. Ah, yeah, you're 21 with a couple of years' experience, as we say. Yes, I'm hitting the big 54 now in May, but I wouldn't change it for the world. I wouldn't want to be any younger. I wouldn't want to be one of the younger generations, because 2 days. Ah, Florida. Ah, yes, I had a very good friend in Florida, lived in Ocala. He was my second in command, actually, on Star Wars Galaxies. He was my main ground forces guy. And he used to run, well, not so much the ground forces. I think he was more for the space fleet. He was in command of everything space. You know, I was just the Grand Admiral. But, yeah, anything to do with that. Yeah. A guy called Chris, Napau his name was. Yeah, we knew him as Napau, and hell of a nice guy. Yeah. Level 42. Now, that was an 80s British band. Level 42. I think they did the song Lessons in Love. Level 42. Yeah. I'm big into music, so I got a wide array of music, really, that I normally... Somebody said that about me, funny enough. They said they'll be trying to take your new rock boots off, Black Sheep, while they're changing your adult nappies in the nursing home while you're gaming on your PC. I said, yeah, way to go. I'm going to go out of this world the way I came in, kicking and screaming. Well, yeah, I've been... It would have been about 1978 or 1979. I went to a friend's house, and he was one of these rich kids of the neighbourhood, you know. And he had everything, you know. He had his own full-size snooker table in part of the house, and he had an arcade in his attic, which was his arcade. We had, you know, he had the original Pac-Man, you know, Space Invaders, Galaxians. He had all these machines, real arcade machines. And then he had the snooker table up there as well, and rich kid of the neighbourhood, but I'd never heard of any gaming in the house. And he also had an Atari VCS, or what we called it, was the 2600, and he put Space Invaders on, and I was like totally blown away that you can connect this thing to the television. So I think it was Christmas 1980, my parents bought me one. And I was so excited, because my favourite game at the time was Berserk with the robot here, and I'd count down, fight like a robot and all this. And then 2 years later, in 82, Christmas 82, my parents bought me an Atari 800 computer with a cassette deck. 15 minutes to load Bruce Lee, you know, on cassette, and it was a great game and stuff. But yeah, my next step then after the 800 was the Atari 520 with Dungeon Master. Oh my god, I loved Dungeon Master, you know. Oh yeah, yeah. And then my next step then was obviously the Commodore. I betrayed my... I was an Atarian and I went over to the Commodore Amiga 500. And my father... I didn't come from a rich family, but he'd been saving for a while. He wanted to get me a hard drive for the Commodore, and he said, find a good one. And I found one which looked like it was a part of the actual computer, a GVP, and that was going for 800 British pounds for a 100 megabyte hard drive. And he bought it for me, and I was like, oh my god. And I'd have it connected to my stereo, which looks like a Christmas tree with all the lights and the dual cassettes and the mini disc and the CD and the record player on the top. And I think it was a JVC stack system. So my Amiga was connected into my JVC, which could connect it to the telly. So a total surround sound back in the, well, the late 80s, early 90s, that would have been. Well, if you go to Epic Games... I can't remember what it's called now, but there's an arcade on Epic Games on the cloud system on there, and it's got all the original arcade games, Space Invaders, Galaxians, Galaga, Defender. It's even got the original Star Wars games from the arcade, and stuff like Dragon's Lair and Gauntlet and all the good games that we played years ago, you know. But yeah, I had the Amiga for a couple of years. I used to play Wings and North and South and Night of the Sky and all the classic games on the Amiga. Super Frog. I used to love Super Frog. Dungeon Master, Eye of the Beholder 1 and 2. And then I got given a computer. It wasn't very good, but I could play Age of Empires 1 on it. Yeah, I think, yeah, it was Age of Empires 1. And I played that for a while, and oh, I was addicted to that. And then... an ex, now many years ago, she built a computer for me, put it together, and that was it. I was into PCs. Well, I'm running a Republic of Gamers PC at the moment. It looks like a very big console with flashing light, and it looks very Sith, you know, black and red, and all the lights going up and down. Yeah, lovely machine. Oh yes. But I can play most games on top settings. You know, I've got a 1070 8GB graphics card in there. I don't need anything new. You know, I mean, people say, "Oh, I've got the 3000 and stuff." I don't care. This does what I needed to do. You know, I'm happy with it. Well, why not? Yeah, stream them. Yeah. I did one about a week ago, I think it was. It's on my, I'm known as Black Sheep, but on Twitch, but on my YouTube account, I'm Barbie Black Sheep. So if you look on Barbie Black Sheep, you can see that I play Phasmophobia, I play Star Wars, obviously, I play Hell Let Loose, Enlisted, what else do I play? 7 Days to Die. I love 7 Days to Die. I've got nearly 9,000 hours on that game over the past 9 years. You know, I built a Star Wars AT-AT as an actual base to survive the zombie hordes every 7 nights. And I usually dig a pit around it, put a portcullis, a drawbridge, so that they can't get across. So they drop into the pit and you just shoot them. And yeah, so if I remember right, the legs are 20 blocks high. And then the body's about the same, getting the shape right for an AT-AT. And then my bedroom was in the neck of the AT-AT. And my living room was in the head, so you'd look out the window at the front, you know, the command thing. Yeah. Oh, yes. But the thing is, here's the thing, right? I've watched Star Wars Return of the Jedi. I like Return of the Jedi. A lot of people don't like the movie. I don't like the Ewoks. I used to hunt Ewoks purposely. And with glee in my eye. On Star Wars Galaxies, I'd get my entire squadron, we land on Endor, we just go out on a massive Ewok and shoot the little bastards. That was my order, excuse the language, but that's what my order was. Yeah. But what is it? Here's a question for you, right? When you watch Return of the Jedi, ignore the no they've added now. For some reason, they thought Vader needs to say it again. Ignore that. The Emperor says something just as Vader picks the Emperor up, and as he's carrying him to throw him, he says something to Vader. I don't know whether it's no Vader or whatever, you know, but he says something to Vader just before Vader throws him down into the reactor. But what does he say? It's not even. I looked the script up earlier, funny enough, and I don't know to this day what he says. Well, whenever I get mad in real life, I just go in. I've got my own Discord. I go into my own rant channel. Certain things annoy me in life. Idiots, mostly. Stupid people get on my nerves. Because you try having a conversation about anything with a stupid person. What's the point? You start thinking like Orwellian. It's like, why do you exist? What is the point of you? You've got no intelligence at all. You can't hold a conversation. Why do you exist? And then you start thinking, perhaps they exist to serve other people like us. It sounds very narcissistic, but it sometimes when you go off on one, you know. Yeah, you check it out, right? And if you can work it out, please come back and tell me, because for 30 odd years, I still don't know what the Emperor said. It might be something as simple as, no, Vader. But he says something, he shouts something at Vader when Vader picks him up. And I still to this day can't work out what he says. And it's not even in the script of the bloody movie, which shocked me. All it says is, you know, he picks him up to stop Luke and Vader takes a lot of the electric into himself. And it doesn't even say it then, what the Emperor says. And I'm like, what? Yeah, I'm supposed to be. I think I'll do another round on you. I won't be doing that. Geonosis. Oh, let's give this a try then. Okay. Geonosis. That's the foundries, isn't it? Yes. The foundry world with the flying insect people. Episode 7, 8, and 9. I wish they'd have gone with the Timothy Zahn books, to be honest, because Heir to the Empire, Dark Force Rising, and The Last Command, that's how it should have ended. But I think what they should have done is a Star Wars story movie, Jakku, explaining how the Imperial machine network was finally defeated, showing the Battle of Jakku as a main part of the film. I think that would have explained it all and tied it together before they brought out Episode 7. You know, the First Order would have actually made sense then, that it's the Emperor's First Order after the defeat of his Imperial Navy and stuff. You could have understood where it went then. But Star Wars story, you know, Jakku would have made sense to me. I remember going to the cinema as a very young teenager to watch. No, I wasn't even a teenager then, was I? No, I wasn't. I was, how old would I have been? 12, going on 13 at the time, to watch The Empire Strikes Back. Oh, when I saw the AT-ATs on the big screen, it was like, wow. Blew me away, and I've been Empire ever since. You know, people say, oh, the Empire, they're evil. They're not evil. The Sith aren't even evil, because at least the Sith fight with compassion in their hearts, with passion. They've got a passion. All right, they don't suffer fools too lightly. Yeah, I'd like to, on Star Wars Galaxies, I went to Dathomir, to the quarantine zone, and I used to go in there quite often, and I would farm the zombie stormtroopers. Yes, zombies do exist in Star Wars. A lot of people don't realise they do. After that Imperial experiment, where they killed an entire crew of a Star Destroyer and chucked them all into the quarantine zone of Dathomir, I used to go in quite often, and I'd farm the zombie stormtroopers for the armour pieces of the Death Troopers. And in my base then, I'd have like the armour standing like on a mannequin. So I'd have Imperial officers, and then I'd have, you know, just beautiful, beautiful, beautiful. Yeah, it's my sister, she can't stand Star Wars, but she's never actually sat down and in-depth watched them, you know, it's always in the background for her. I tried talking to her about Star Wars, and she goes off into her own world, you know. I think she starts playing a song in her head, and that's it. She's living in her own head then, while I'm talking about Star Wars. You know, I get people like that in life. They start talking crap to me, and I'm da 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 da. That's all I can hear then, is the Archer's theme too. It's yeah. I used to have a friend years ago. He'd always talk about what he did in work that day. It's like people are talking about their kids non-stop. It's like, oh yeah, my interest level peaked at 0%. Can you please stop, like? I've got three kids of my own, like. call me Clanker, will you? Bucket boy. Yes. You know, people knocked episode 1, 2 and 3. I actually quite like the first three films. Excluding Jar Jar Binks, obviously, because even I got my limits. When they said he could be a Sith Lord, I just laughed. But no, they wouldn't be that cruel to us, would they? Troopers. Somebody had me with a nice shot, didn't he? So yeah, I hope your day's going well for you today. Nice to see there are some of us still left out here, Star Wars fans. So apparently, Star Wars is dumb, man. Star Wars is dumb. Yeah. If I believed that, I wouldn't be able to resist, you know? If it wasn't for Star Wars, they wouldn't have all their, I won't say crap movies, but they wouldn't have their special effects movies much. So they don't realise that Star Wars is what made it possible for them to have those films. Us clunkers, boy.
Grenade prime.
Bucket head on for that. They've really sorted these maps out, I'll give them that. Whoa. I'm from Wales in the UK, by the way, that's where my accent comes from. Geonosis is alright to the planet, isn't it? One red rock's as good as another, I suppose. Defeat these baskets. Yeah, I'll be calling it after this one. I got a few things I need to get done. Otherwise, I get more than that, you know what I mean? As you do. But yeah. I'm just glad you're having a good day, man. Nice to meet you as well, like. Good luck, that. They might be shit, these droids, but they are funny. Roger. They could have picked a better voice for them, could they really? Just suit them so well, like. Swear then, did my droid actually just swear? Darth Battle Droid. Did he just show cock? Bobby Clanker. There for the separatist. Yes, yes, yes. Do you play Phasmophobia, my friend, if you're still there? Right, well, I'm going to be pulling the stream for now. I will be back in a little while. I've got a few things to do. It's just gone midday here, so plenty of time to go. And I will catch you later. Thanks for being with me, King. And lovely to learn you're a Star Wars fan. Keep the belief going in the universe of Star Wars. If you're on Soto at all, I'm known as Darth Morticia on there. She looks like Darth Nihilus. She's usually on the Darth Malgus server. So if you're on there and you want to give her a shout out, feel free. If not, I'll catch you soon. You take care of yourselves. And it's Black Sheep out for now. Stay safe and look after yourselves. Have fun.